When I replaced the motherboard of this Athlon 64 machine, it kinda bugged me that there was no I/O shield included. So I bought blank I/O shields from AliExpress for a few Western coins. But now what? How do you actually make this into a fitting I/O shield? I have no idea, but I'm gonna try it anyway. No, really, I have no idea. So you might see me do things that could have been done way easier and or better. Let me know in the comments if you do. So first I took a picture with my phone of the back of the computer and loaded that into GIMP to cut only the missing I/O shield part. Zoomed in a few times to make sure I got it as close as possible. I pasted that as a new image and used the perspective tool to make it a rectangle again. This step is very important since the photo I took isn't perfectly straight. The result I copied and pasted in LibreOffice Draw so I could print it at the right size. I changed the width to 4.45 cm and the height to 15.88 cm because I found online that the dimensions of an I/O shield should be 158.75 mm by 44.45 mm. And since LibreOffice Draw apparently doesn't support anything smaller than a tenth of a millimeter or 1/100 of a centimeter to be precise, I rounded those numbers upwards. I printed in grayscale to save some ink. You don't need this in color, but it doesn't hurt either. Do make sure it's set to original size though, so it prints the image in the dimensions we entered before. Alright, so here's the hopefully rightly scaled result. I figured it would be a good idea to cut the image with a knife, but don't ask why, I should have just used scissors. Here's a blank I/O shield. Seems about right. Let's cut the ports out. I quickly found out that this knife didn't cut it, so I borrowed some small scissors from my children instead. That went a lot better. Isn't it amazing? Seems to fit reasonably well. Maybe I should just keep it like this. Nah. Let's transfer the holes onto the blank plate. Drawing the holes at the front seemed a bad idea because of the border around it. So I turned it around and used a Sharpie to mark the holes. Now what? I still have no idea, but let's take it to the garage and figure something out. Let's drill some small holes, somewhat in the center of where the actual hole should be. I did try to directly drill the larger hole, but that didn't seem to be a good idea. So back to drilling small ones first. Alright, make the holes great again. By the way, don't do what I'm doing here because...
Ow.
So after patching myself up, I took some small pieces of wood and clamped it in my bench vise instead of stupidly holding it with my hands. Took it out again to drill some small holes to start on the cutouts for the VGA and parallel ports. Yeah, this is for a PC that's old enough to have a few driver's licenses of its own. Hey, did I mention I have no idea what it is I'm doing? Back into the vise before I hurt myself again! So the screw holes for the parallel and VGA ports are in place. I figured the Dremel would be the tool for the bigger parts. I took a piece of wood and screwed the soon-to-be I/O shield on top of it, so I could clamp it in the vise again while still being able to reach it with a Dremel from the top. That worked quite well. Oops, little too far. Ah, well. Damn, time for a new wheel already. Back in business. Alright, it does look like an I/O shield. An ugly one, but an I/O shield nonetheless. Let's see if it'll fit. Not really. I need to drill some bigger holes. So I did that and did some filing and stuff, thinking I was filming it, until I wanted to stop the recording and started the recording. Oops. Let's try to fit it again. Not yet. The parallel port doesn't fit through and I can't use the PS2 ports like this either. Back to the garage to do some more drilling and filing and sanding and more filing and more sanding. Yeah, it's ugly as f**k. It's starting to look as if it's going to fit. Let's just give it a try. Disconnect everything. Take the board out. Yeah, seems okay. PS2 ports seem clear and the rest looks kinda okay. Let's just put it in. The board still fits! Woohoo! Connecting everything again. PS2 still fits. USB ports as well. Network ports clear. Let's just connect it and see if she still works. I could use USB peripherals here, but I figured I'd take a PS2 keyboard and mouse to check if those work. Bit tight on the mouse board, but it fits. Let's connect my VGA to HDMI thingy. It uses USB for power. VGA connects fine as well. Connected to network, because why wouldn't I connect a Windows XP machine to the internet? We've got a visual! Well, the keyboard works.
Woohoo!
Sounds working as well. I think we're kinda done here. Yeah, my website works. Well, kinda. But at least no connectivity issues. So was it worth it? I'd say it definitely looks better than the big gap that was there before. It might not be the neatest IO shield, but just don't look too closely, right? At the very least, it will help to keep a bit of dust out. Does it really need to be aluminium though? Can't you just make one out of cardboard? A piece of plastic? Maybe 3D print something? Yeah, probably. But this is more shiny! That's it for today. I hope you liked this video. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time!